So a duck walks into a bar. So a duck walks into a bar. So a duck walks into a bar. So a duck walks into a bar and asks the bartender for a few drinks. So a duck walks into a bar and orders a few drinks. The bartender tells him, "Hey, you're just a duck. How are you going to pay for all these drinks you've ordered?" And the duck says,
"Sam, you're on in two."
"All right, Mr. Grimley."
"Buford, we need to check your central transmitter."
"Sounds good, Mr. Grimley." "Say, Sam, you think I could borrow some of your oil?"
"Hey, how's the arm?"
"Yeah, it's still a little worse for wear, but it works." "Thanks, pal." "Good luck with that joke of yours."
"Hey, you think they're gonna like it?"
"Are you kidding? For crying out loud, you're Sarsaparilla Sam. The audience loves you. See you out there, partner."
"All right, see ya."
"Jig is up, Buford. Your days of stealing my pizza are done. Put your filthy hands where I can see them, you dirty rat."
"Joe, go on and chat forever, Sam, you caught me. Your good looks and boyish charm have done it again. But I reckon you didn't expect me."
"Dynamite!"
"I'm giving you to the count of three. And if that delicious pepperoni pizza isn't in my pudgy little hands by then, I'll blow this whole saloon to smithereens."
"I love you, Buford."
"Shut your trap, you varmint."
"Today, Buford, as long as I'm big bug in this saloon, ain't nobody laying their hands on my hot and delicious pepperoni pizza." "Well, I hope you folks had a mighty fine day here at my saloon, and I hope this old bog trotter didn't spoil our fun. Now, as you city slickers mosey on out of here, be sure to try our new Hawaiian-style pizza. Get a taste of the islands without ever stepping foot on a plane. All right, I'll see y'all real soon. Happy trails." "But before y'all leave, I have something I would like to share. It's a joke, and I would like to perform it for you, if you care to stay and watch. So a duck walks into a bar and orders a few drinks. And the bartender says,
Sam,
sorry, folks. It looks like Sam got stuck in some molasses. As you mosey on out of here, make sure to check out the shooting gallery. Don't forget to throw away your pizza and make sure to recycle. Have a root and tooth today!
So, what did the bartender say, Sam?
So a duck walks into a bar and asks for a few drinks. And the bartender asks the duck how he's gonna pay for all the drinks that he's ordered. And the duck says, just put it on my bill.
I've been observing your onstage behaviors the past few weeks, and I'm starting to see a pattern. Do you have any idea what that might be?
Maybe I go off script sometimes?
14 times in the past week. Improvised lines, missed cues, and now you're telling jokes.
Well, I thought it might be exciting for the audience if we tried something different.
We've been doing the same show for 30 years now. I'd know if we need to do something different. We don't.
But if we did, I think it would be a great opportunity for us to push the creative boundary.
Sam. You're one of the most advanced animatronics ever manufactured. I'm certain you can comprehend that Sarsaparilla Sam's Saloon is really just a family-friendly arcade that sells pizza. This isn't the place for groundbreaking, theatrical, whatever. This is you.
This pizza is rootin' tootin'.
Now you do the show exactly as written, and our customers stay long. When they do that, they spend more money on pizza and games. Now, if you don't perform the show that our customers have come to know and love, they're confused. They leave. They don't spend money. You and I would be out of a job without our customers. Now, if you refuse to do the show as scripted, I have no choice but to replace you with something that can.
I understand, Mr. Grimley. And I know that I was programmed to entertain, but I feel like I could do so much more.
The audience doesn't care what you have come to say. They're not here for you. They're here for Sarsaparilla Sam. Show's on in 2 minutes. Go get him, cowboy.
I just want one teensy, weensy bite. Bite. I just want one teensy, weensy bite of that delicious, cheesy pepperoni pizza. Oh! Oh, breadsticks.
You ain't getting one bite of this sizzling slice. This pizza is
rootin' tootin'. Sarsaparilla Sam 1, Buford zilch.
Action!
Hi, I'm Sarsaparilla Sam. And when it comes to pizza, trust me, I know what I'm talking about when I say that Sarsaparilla Sam's frozen pizza is the best you're gonna find at your local grocery store. With authentic Italian flavors and just a dash of barbecue sauce, I can guarantee that Sarsaparilla Sam's pizza is rootin' tootin'. And when you're done, be sure to wet your whistle with my signature drink. A sarsaparilla, of course.
And cut! That was great.
I can do it another way if you like.
No, I think we're good. Hey, let's move on to our next shot.
Thanks, Sam!
No problem.
Howdy, Sam.
Howdy, cowboy. What can I do for you?
Could you sign this for me?
Sure thing.
Here. Oh, can you say that thing about the pizza?
Yeah.
This pizza is rootin' tootin'. Anything else you guys like me to say? Maybe something that's not from the show?
That's okay. Thanks, anyways. Hi, Sam.
Sorry, kid. I think I'm done
signing autographs today.
That's okay. I already got tons of those. I just wanted to ask you something.
What's that?
What did the bartender say to that duck? I've been thinking about it all week.
Well, the bartender asks the duck how he's going to pay for all those drinks he's ordered. And the duck tells him, just put it on my bill.
Put it on my bill, because a duck has a bill, right?
That's right.
I like that one. I just wish you could say more jokes like that in the show.
Me too.
Oh, I know you're busy running the saloon and all, so I wanted to give this to you before you leave.
This looks terrific. Thank you, June. Who told you to make this?
What do you mean?
You mean no one told you what to draw? You drew this all by yourself?
Yeah.
June, come on. We're going to the shooting gallery.
Bye, Sam.
Buford, take a look at this draw. Mr. Grimley, where are they taking Buford?
Buford didn't operate like he used to. He was getting older.
He was manufactured the same year I was.
Machines break down, parts break. Today it was Buford, someday it'll be you. Buford's replacement will be coming within the week. I hate to see him go just as much as you do, but this is what's best for the show.
Mr. Grimley, turn it over.
What is it?
Well, you said I can't go off script anymore.
You can't.
So I wrote a new show. That way, I can't go off script. Let me know what you think.
I can't read this.
Why not? Oh, right. Well, you know what? I think it actually might be better if you let me perform it for you, rather than have you read it. What do you say? I spent all night working on that. You didn't even give me a chance to perform it.
I know what's best. Whatever you wrote wouldn't have worked.
What do you know about what works and what doesn't? You've never stepped foot on that stage. But you're the one who gets to decide what I can perform? That show that I wrote is good. I know it is. I'm the one doing the show. I'm the one out there every single day. I should be the one who gets to decide what I get to perform, not you.
You need to understand that you're not in a position to make those decisions. I am. Nothing you do is going to change that.
Well, if I don't have a say in what I can do, then I won't perform for you anymore.
What are you going to do then, Sarsaparilla Sam? If you reject what you were built for, what use will you have? Without this show, you have no further function. The only thing standing between you and a pile of scrap metal is me. So I'm going to give you a choice. Either you accept what you were built to do, or you can be deactivated and disassembled, just like Buford.
It's up to you now, Sam. What will you choose?
To me, you said Buford was going to be dismantled, that he was going to be replaced.
Our engineers found that assembling a replacement animatronic for Buford would be untimely and expensive. Reprogramming his central transmitter, however, has proved to be far more efficient. If we reprogram Buford to be in character both on and off stage, we eliminate any unnecessary movements that may result in his parts breaking down again.
You're taking away who he is.
This is who he is. Just like you, he is built to do and be one thing. Which brings me to something I want you to hear. The engineers will be watching the show tomorrow to run a final diagnostics on Buford. And afterward, they'll reprogram you.
You're slippery as a catfish, Sam. You ain't going nowhere.
Buford, take him to the dressing room and watch him until tomorrow. Sam. I gave you a choice. This is what's best for the show.
The jig is up, Buford. Your days of stealing my pizza are done for. Put your filthy hands where I can see them, you dirty rat.
Doggone it, Sarsaparilla Sam, you caught me. Your good looks and boyish charm have done it again.
But I reckon you didn't expect
dynamite!
I'm giving you to the count of three, and if that delicious pepperoni pizza isn't in my pudgy little hands by then, I'll blow this whole saloon to smithereens.
Shut your trap, you varmint! Mm.
two.
Well, folks, I appreciate your time. I appreciate y'all coming. Thank you.